Hello students, how are you? Now again we are here to see some more new articles regarding our chapter work, energy and power. In our previous module, what we did, we have seen sir, what is work done by a constant force, that is equal to work done by our force into displacement. And angle in between force and displacement. Now today we are going to learn work done by a variable force. Is it clear? Yes. Now today we are going to learn work done by a variable force. Work done by a variable force we are going to see. Let us see here. We know very well a constant force is rare. It is very difficult to get constant force anywhere. It is a variable force which is encountered. More commonly we can see variable force. So my dear children, we can therefore learn to calculate work done by a variable force. Is it clear? Now, for the sake of simplicity, let us consider a force acting along the fixed direction, say along x-axis. See in this diagram, here it is a distance. Here it is the force. This is our x-axis and this is our y-axis. Force acting along the fixed direction, say x-axis, but having a variable magnitude like this. Here, say it is C point, here is D point. I have to calculate work done in moving the body, say from the point A to the point B. You can see in this figure, body is moving from the point A to the point B, but force is varying. Then how I can calculate the work done here? So what I have to do, dear children, here? To do this, I assume that entire displacement from A to B is made up of a large number of infinite small displacement, and one such displacement, you divide the complete figure in a small displacement like this. Here, and out of which I am taking here, and a strip say PQRS. Here, I am taking this strip here. Here, PQ is equal to DX. It is a very small, I consider that all along this displacement, force is constant. Here, from P to Q, I am considering here, the force is constant in magnitude, say PS. The force here is PS. The force is constant in magnitude as well as in direction. So according to our formula, from here to here, small amount of work done in moving the body from P to Q. When I am moving from P to Q, the work done would be small amount of work done. Force is constant, displacement is dx. F dot dx, here F is equal to PS and dx is equal to PQ, that is the area of this strip. This is the area of the strip PQRS. Now, if I want to find out the total work done in moving the body from the point A to the point B, so I have to calculate area of each strip and I can sum up it. So W is equal to, I can write summation of dW. दिस इज अ साइन ऑफ सिग्मा और समेशन. तो आई कैन राइट हियर सिग्मा एफ डी एक्स हियर. इफ द डिस्प्लेसमेंट आर अलाउडेड टू अप्रोच जीरो देन द नंबर ऑफ टर्म्स इन द सम इंक्रीजेस विदाउट लिमिट. सो माय डियर चिल्ड्रन आई कैन राइट W is equal to limit dx tends to 0 here summation f dx. So I can say here in the language of integral calculus I can rewrite it. Integration kar lijiye iska to find out within a limit, say this point is x a and here is the point is x b. So limit x a to x b f dx. This is the way to find out the sum of all these. You convert it into an integral calculus. This is called integration. What is this? It is called integration. So I can write here f dx, where x a जो आपको दिखलाया गया है, what is x a? That is o a. x a here is x a is equal to o a and x b is equal to o b here, not this, sorry for that. This is here o a, this is equal to x a and here it is equal to xb. Total amount of work done would be xa to xb f dx. We can write this. So this w is equal to integration from xa to xb, that is the area of abcda, area of A, B, C, D, A. This is the way to find out the work done here. The work done by a variable force here is numerically equal to the area under the force curve. This is the area complete. Area under the force curve and the displacement axis. This is equal to work done by a variable force. Is that clear? Yes, sir. Now, so this is the formula in a mathematical form. We have to use later on in numerical point of view. Write down. Now, so this is there. Now I am going to learn a new article along with you. That is, what is conservative forces? What do you mean by conservative forces? So we are going to learn conservative force and non-conservative force. So my dear children, a force is said to be conservative if work done by, if work done by or against the force, work done by or against the force on a moving body, in a moving body depends only on the initial and final position of the body. The initial and final position of the body. And not on the nature of the path. ऐसा फोर्स जो पाथ पर डिपेंड नहीं करता है, It totally depends on initial and final position of the object. That type of force is called conservative force. I mean to say that work done by or against the conservative force in moving a body over any path between fixed initial and final position will be the same. That I am going to prove. For example, I can say the gravitational force. The conservative force. I am going to prove here. Gravitational force is a conservative force. I have to prove. For that, let us calculate amount of work done. We are going to calculate amount of work done in gravitational force in a different path. In moving a body M, say through a height AB, say it is the first case, this point is say A, it is B, body is going vertically upwards, say at height H. Ek path ye le lijiye. In a second manner, you take an inclined plane. Suppose you are going from C to B, but height is H. We are going along this path, but the height remains same. And in the third path, I am going in this manner, like this. But again the height is same. Here is figure C and here is figure D. And in the fourth path, suppose I can say the body is going in this manner, zigzag path. Here is the figure B. I am going from the point at height H. All the four figures, the height is same. See, in this first figure, once we are going like this, in this figure A, the work done would be, force into displacement. That is F S cos theta. Here the weight of the body here is mg. Body is moving from A to B. Here the distance from A to B is H. I can calculate here W1 is equal to F. The force acting over here is mg. Height is h. The angle here is 0. So it is cos 0. Cos 0 is 1. The work done is mgh along this path AB in figure A. So my dear children, I can write here. This is W1 is equal to mgh. In the second path, I am having an inclined plane, force applied, say the body is going like this, here is the body, and the force applied like this, the weight of the body, here is mg, the normal reaction force, it is R, it makes an angle theta here, component of mg along the axis, that is along where the angle is meet, that is equal to mg cos theta, and the perpendicular here it is mg sin theta. So this force F is balanced by mg sin theta. Distance moved along the path CB. So what is the work done in figure B? Work done in figure B, here, this is the figure B. Work done here is force and displacement is CB. Here again FCB cos 0, angle is 0. In the force and displacement here, to my dear children, its angle is theta here. What is F? F is balanced by mg sin theta. Here it is mg sin theta एंड सीबी इंटू सीबी, तो ये एम जी साइन थीटा, साइन थीटा इज इक्वल टू परपेंडिकुलर अपॉन हाइपोटेनियस. व्हाट इज दैट परपेंडिकुलर हियर इन दिस एंगल, सी दैट द परपेंडिकुलर इज ए बी अपॉन सी बी इंटू सी बी, तो सी बी से सी बी कैंसिल, एम जी इंटू ए बी, ए बी इज इक्वल टू एच. अगेन यू सी दैट दिस वर्क डन डब्ल्यू टू अलोंग दिस पाथ इज ऑल्सो इक्वल टू एम जी एच. इट इज क्लियर. तो आई कैन राइट हियर, हियर आई एम राइटिंग अगेन, सी दैट द डब्ल्यू टू इज इक्वल टू एफ सी बी, दैट इज एफ सी बी कॉस जीरो, दैट इज इक्वल टू एफ इज इक्वल टू एम जी साइन थीटा, एम जी साइन थीटा इंटू सी बी, दैट इज इक्वल टू एम जी साइन थीटा इज इक्वल टू ए बी अपॉन सी बी इंटू सी बी, दैट इज एम जी इंटू ए बी, ए बी इज इक्वल टू एच. दिस इज द इक्वेशन नंबर टू. नाउ इन फिगर सी, हियर वी आर हैविंग स्टेयर्स, वी आर गोइंग इन दिस मैनर, एंड इन दिस फिगर सपोज this height is h dash and this is distance is x, and say the number of the stairs is n, then how I can calculate the work done here? Total height from a to b is same again h. I can calculate in figure c w3 is equal to the total number of stairs is n. First I am going like this, weight of the body is mg, so mg h dash cos 0 here, from here to here mg h dash angle is 0, but when we are going like this weight is downward, so I can write mg in the horizontal distance is x cos 90 here, from here to here. तो माय डियर चिल्ड्रन, नंबर ऑफ स्टेयर्स एन एम जी एच डैस, दिस इज जीरो, कॉस 90 इज इक्वल टू जीरो, एम जी एन एच डैस नंबर ऑफ स्टेयर्स, एच डैस एच डैस एच डैस, एन एच डैस आई कैन राइट हियर इज एच. दिस इज आवर इक्वेशन नंबर थर्ड. तो डब्ल्यू वन डब्ल्यू टू एंड डब्ल्यू थ्री ऑल आर सेम, वी कैन से हियर. Now, in the fourth case here, it is a zigzag path. Here you can say, in figure D, here, this is the figure. In figure D shows that body moving carried through the same height A to B H over any arbitrary zigzag path. Or I can say, when the body is moving like this, say along this dr, along this dx, and along this dy, ye dr. Now, how I can calculate? So in this figure, you see that arbitrary zigzag path. So how I calculate the work done? The height from A to B is h. This path can be supposed to be a made up of large number of small horizontal displacement dx. We can say small horizontal displacement dx and vertical displacement here dh. The vertical displacement is dh. So work done would be in figure D, see that summation of mg DH, पहले वर्टिकल डिस्प्लेसमेंट देखिए, DH बोथ आर इन द सेम डायरेक्शन तो एंगल इज जीरो, बट अलोंग दिस डिस्प्लेसमेंट समेशन MG एंड द ओरिजेंटल डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज DX, बट एंगल ये इज 90 डिग्री. सो आई कैन राइट दिस इज जीरो हियर एंड दिस विल इक्वल टू अगेन MGH. तो विद द हेल्प ऑफ इक्वेशन 1, 2, 3, 4, W1 इज इक्वल टू W2 इज इक्वल टू W3 इज इक्वल टू W4, दिस इज द रिजल्ट. तो विद दिस एग्जाम्पल आई कैन से द पाथ इज डिफरेंट. फ्रॉम दिस डिस्कशन आई फाउंड दैट W1, W2, W3 एंड W4 वर्क डन इज द सेम. वॉट एवर बी द पाथ टू रीच फ्रॉम द पॉइंट ए टू द पॉइंट बी, ए टू द पॉइंट बी बिटवीन द इनिशियल पोजिशन ए एंड फाइनल पोजिशन बी, तो आई एस्टेब्लिश दैट द ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स, राइट डाउन द ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स इज ए कंजर्वेटिव फोर्स. ये प्रूव करने का एग्जाम आएगा. प्रूव दैट कंजर्वेटिव फोर्स, ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स इज ए कंजर्वेटिव फोर्स. नाउ द एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ अदर कंजर्वेटिव फोर्सेज आर, वन एग्जाम्पल वी हैव सीन ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स, फोर्स इन एन इलास्टिक स्प्रिंग, फोर्स इन एन इलास्टिक स्प्रिंग. इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक फोर्स दैट वी विल सी इन 12th क्लास, द इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक फोर्स बिटवीन टू इलेक्ट्रिक चार्जेस, बिटवीन टू इलेक्ट्रिक चार्जेस मैग्नेटिक फोर्स बिटवीन द टू मैग्नेटिक पोल्स, मैग्नेटिक फोर्स बिटवीन द टू मैग्नेटिक पोल्स, दैट ऑल्सो वी विल सी इन 12th क्लास. तो दीज आर द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ कंजर्वेटिव फोर्सेस. राइट डाउन नाउ व्हाट आर द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ कंजर्वेटिव फोर्सेस. The properties of conservative forces. What are the properties of conservative forces? First, we have proved. So, work done by or work done by or against the conservative force or work done by or against a conservative force, conservative force in moving a body from, in moving a body, in moving a body from one position to the another position, in moving a body from one position to the another, one position to the another depends only on the initial and final position of the body, initial and final position of the body. That we have proved. What is the second property? Work done by or against the conservative force does not depend upon the nature of the path. Does not depend on nature of the path. it does not depend on the nature of path that we have seen in last example, followed by the body in going from initial position to the final position. And the third one is work done by or against the conservative force in moving a body through any round trip. So what I can say, in moving a body through a round trip जहां से रवाना हो वापिस लौट के वहीं आ गया, दैट इज क्लोज पाथ. सपोज इट स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द पॉइंट ए गोइंग टू द पॉइंट बी एंड अगेन कमिंग टू द पॉइंट ए, दिस इज द क्लोज पाथ. वी कैन से हियर इट इज गोइंग फ्रॉम ए टू बी एंड अगेन कमिंग फ्रॉम बी टू ए. तो व्हाट आई कैन से हियर, व्हेन इट इज गोइंग फ्रॉम A to B and again here B, here it is B and again from B to A, it is called closed path. So in moving a body through a round trip or a closed path where final position coincides with the initial position, it is the initial position and again it is the final position, is always zero. In moving a body through a closed trip or round trip, the work done should be zero. So these are the important properties of a conservative force. So you have to write in your copy. Now, the other kind of force is a non-conservative force. Most of the forces available in the nature are non-conservative force. That is, what is the meaning of it? The non-conservative force, now what do we mean by non-conservative force? Non-conservative force, what is this? Non-conservative force, that is a force is said to be non-conservative if work done by or against force, by or against a force, work done by or against a force, against the force in moving a body from one position to the another, from one position to the another, एक जगह से दूसरे जगह तक जाने में किया गया काम depends on the path followed, depends on the path followed, depends on the path followed between these two positions. Between these two positions, here, for example, frictional force are called non-conservative force. If you are going from A to B on a rough surface, not smooth surface, so we can say if a body is moved from a position A to the position B, say this is A and here is the position B, you are going in this rough surface, so work done against the frictional force, it shall depends on the length of the path between A and B and not on the position of path A and B. इस समय A से B तक जाने में लगा हुआ कार्य, किया हुआ काम is not equal to the work done in moving the body from B to A. So I can say in a frictional force net work done in a round trip over a closed path is not zero. Is it clear? That is called non-conservative force. So another example of non-conservative force is the induction force. That is induction force that acts a device called in our physics cyclotron. We will see in 12th class where an induction force acts. The charged particle returns to its initial position with more kinetic energy than what it had originally. That's why at that time the force acting over is non-conservative force in a device cyclotron. Write down, these are the conservative force and non-conservative force. Is that clear? So dear children, this is all about today. Today we saw work done by a variable force, conservative force, non-conservative force with examples. Okay, bye.